Hello guys, welcome to my next guide. As of today, it's the 4th and the next will be released the 5th of January, which is tomorrow. So I took by myself, I will introduce a little bit earlier on what is next and how to kill. I am, as I speak of, talking about Eris 3 and old school, oh sorry, Eris 2 as well. Therefore, in old school RuneScape, it might differ a little bit. Of course, I will show you guys a full run of how I'm gonna kill next on release with my team or whatever, or just, you know, in the group. We will shall see and talk along the way. So what I know for next, she has 5 phases: smoke, ice, blood, and shadow. Those are the 4 phases actually of the ancient magics, but she has 5, as I earlier already said, which is the last phase, and I will conclude that as heal, because in the last phase she basically soul split, so the soul split phase. For those who don't know, soul split is whenever you deal some damage and you activate that prayer on RS3 or old school RuneScape, perhaps it will actually heal back a little bit. It's like a Blood Fury and a Sang kind of deal. So I know Nex has Blood Reavers in phase 3 often, which in Eris 3 and Eris 2 actually you needed to kill them because they healed Nex. So I assume by killing it, either Blood Burst it, maybe Sight if they're underneath each other. But I will go with melee, I will explain later on. Actually, how do you get to next? You need a frozen key. For each frozen key piece, you need to kill one of the respective gods there already are. Bendos, Kriara, Armadil, and Zamorak. You also have Edumenzio keys, which you can require in the wilderness up to 5 pieces at a time. Therefore, you don't need kill counts. So I actually made here a quick overview of my presets. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wear everything respectively of every and each god. So from Bendos towards Armadil towards Zara, Zamorak, and last but not least Ancients, therefore Saros. You as well can see clearly that we have here the Edumenzio key, so we don't need kill count, and perhaps teleport out and stamina's. So this is the gear that I'm gonna rock with. I actually have 2 gear setup that I wanna talk about. This is a little bit of the higher end gear setup. I took by myself, I have no idea whether Thibaut is best in slot or not, so I'm just gonna rock it first thing and just check it out. We shall see. So always Elytion is pretty much best in slot everywhere since it negates all, you know, hits, quote unquote. And I took by myself, Shadow Phase had a huge drain back in the days in prayer. So I think I might start off phase 1 with a spectral. So we save up a lot of prayers. And phase 2 and further along the way, I will either use the Thibaut with this setup, or I will use still the spectral if that's best in slot. So my predictions actually are that this setup might be the best. Consider maybe a Bova, maybe. Let's go to the second setup. So the second setup is actually not bad. It's more melee based, therefore we have of course our melee setup here. I don't want to have a full switch, especially not in a mass on day of release. Therefore, only weapons is fine. That's the reason why we go with Carols over Arims. Arims negates attack bonus, which Carols does not. I don't have an ACB, so I just gonna use a Dragon Hunter crossbow. And a Bova just to check it out. The reason that I might, you know, need them Phoenix necklace would be phase 4, where actually you can be imprisoned by ice, and if somebody doesn't open you, I'm solely talking about, you know, Eris 3 and Eris through. You will get a lot of damage, therefore if you click it prior to that you get frozen, you might survive. Of course, always go with either Vengeance, because maybe you can Venge that 90 or whatever that she's gonna pop up out of the blue, can be redeemed, or otherwise, if you wanna be best in slot with DPS, which a lot of people might wanna do, go with Trawlers. So we're gonna eat up completely and show the all girl kill. So let's go here. Spawn a dude over here. I'm gonna stand here and then instantly attack. So we're gonna maybe already do something like this. We attack Fume. So we are out of her range right now. She cannot really drag us in. Oh, she's actually tanking me. I'm tanking. Yikes. I don't want to be a tank. I rather not. Okay, cool. She's off now. That's good. Okay, we didn't get hit by all the shadows. Next minion. Okay, we definitely need restores because the drain is real. Okay, next wave, Blood Reavers are gonna spawn. You kind of need to either kill the Blood Reavers or you just stay on next in the mess, I guess. Trawlers are out, so let's do a new Trawler. Okay, so we need to go to this over here, but stay away from her because she will do the contain in phase 4. And you really don't want to be near the contain at all. But that's a blood hit, so she's gonna heal. Contain is like spikes, ice spikes. As you can see right here. That's not too bad, not too bad. So the next skill is gonna be Glaciers. She imprisons somebody over there. So, oof, we lagging. Do one hit in. I think this is a drop for me, but I don't know for sure. Watch out for the area of effect damage. It's about 4x4 as it seems to be. I did not get loot over there. Oh, then we need to teleport. That's a yikes. So we're starting, of course, with a trawler towards here. Gonna spam click once it's actually available for a red axe on him. So we have the first game tick already on it. The moment it says Fumus, you go on Fumus. The second it's that, you change towards ranging. Gonna walk up a little bit. It says Umbra, so that's the next one. We're gonna kill Umbra. Protect for ranging magic again. For the next skill, so we go clockwise, for those who don't know. We drag the boss a little bit wrong. You wanna kill the Blood Reavers, but in a mess it's not needed. So now you're gonna kill the third one, Courier. And we go on this one. Phase 4 will contain of two special attacks. The first one is actually a contain. Very dangerous. You're gonna kill the minion. And the next one is prison. But we kill it so fast that the prison isn't even there. Honestly, we kill it that fast. And if you are in the prison, you just spam click yourself out. Or, well, I will say equip the Phoenix necklace. And then let your friends open you. Otherwise, proc your Phoenix. The other thing to do is, once you kill him in phase 5, when he dies, he explodes area of effect, pretty much the same as a retribution. So watch out for that. And that's the whole kill. Please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. And follow me on twitch.tv/qualitycontentstream. Have a good one. Bye.